Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a look for you that I don't recommend you to ever try at home, really. I'm gonna use makeup that's probably expired. A little while back I saw ShanExO do this, I think she made it up herself, so it's not really a tag yet. But it's like forgotten makeup tag thing, like it could be a tag if more people try it out, probably with... It will probably be better to repurchase the products instead of like using very old, probably not very sanitized ones. But anyway, point being, it's just meant to be a thing of using makeup that you used to use a lot, that you used to love, and then it just got stuck in the back of a drawer and not ever used again. I saw her do that and I was like, hey, I can do that too, because I actually am a bit of a hoarder. I have a lot of old stuff lying about. I even have a broken printer in the back of the attic, and a broken television, and a pan flute, which is not broken by the way, and a broken keyboard, and lots of empty cardboard boxes. I have a bit of an issue maybe. Anyway, I should tidy up the place, but for now it's good because we do have enough makeup to do this tag with. Obviously, again, I don't recommend using expired makeup ever, but do as I say, not as you do. Anyway, if my hair looks like a bit of a mess, that's because I went to the cinema earlier today on my bicycle. I saw Birds of Prey, it was really cool. I want to buy a blonde wig and want to film a Harley Quinn-inspired makeup look soon. Probably gonna do that next week, so for me next week, and then for you once you see this, it's going to be up probably next week for you too. But yeah, anyway, let's get started on this makeup challenge. Pulled you up a little bit closer to start off with. Like I said, I went to the cinema in the morning and I'm vain enough that I don't want to go there without any makeup on, even though I went there by myself. I didn't want anyone to startle. Point being, I used concealer and powder and I also did an eyeliner, so I had to wash it off. Back in the day, I didn't actually used to be that serious about skincare, which was very visible because my skin was very, very malnourished and oily because of that reason. I have naturally oily skin, but if I don't take care of it properly, it just gets worse. So yeah, I just did what I did back in the day and used the L'Oreal Skin Perfection as my only moisturizer on both eyes and face and also as a primer. It's not a bad product, by the way, by any means. It works well on me, it's just not technically the most ideal thing for my oily skin, and also I prefer to use a serum and a specific eye cream and not just one moisturizer and that's it. But yeah, we're gonna try it for today. I'm also going to use this little hair thingy because back in the day everyone used to use this. I have no idea if my bangs are actually going to fall forward again as they should once I take this off again, but we'll see. First thing I'm using is the Catrice, like people who've been following me for a long time on YouTube probably recognize this, the Catrice Camouflage Skin Cream, Camouflage Cream, duh. I can't even say it anymore like I used to. Catrice Camouflage Cream in Ivory. I used to use this stuff, it's a cream concealer, I used to use it as an eye primer to fix up my eyebrows, as a concealer obviously. And I've also been known to use it as a full foundation base because it is actually my shade, like it's pale like me. So I think I'm just going to basically very broadly apply this. I'm not going to put it over my entire face, but anywhere where I'm slightly red, I'm going to put this stuff. I don't know how my skin is going to feel about this, because obviously it's not a liquid, it feels a bit more drying. But we'll see. We're just going to hope for the best. Now, I'm not going to lie, it does look very pale and it does look a bit dry. But I'm not hating it. I actually kind of like it. If I remember correctly, it does go oily pretty quickly. But anyway, for powder, I'm using my Catrice powder. This is technically not a forgotten product, but this is just a product that I used to use and I still use, either Catrice or Essence. But I still actually use those powders just from day to day because they're very cheap and they work. Unfortunately, like, I do have spares of every single product I regularly use, except for this. So now I'm just trying to scrape the tiniest bits from the edges of the pan in order to still somehow manage to set my face properly. It's an adventure. And to reduce the glow, at least for the time being, I'm just also going to put it with a big brush all over the rest of my face, obviously. The powder, I mean. And yeah, like, it might look nice now, but come to think of it, Like, on me it goes very, very much too glowy because I have oily skin. But a cream foundation, not necessarily a cream concealer as a foundation, but an actual cream foundation might actually be very nice for people with oily skin. With dry skin, I mean, because they're more oily. Cream foundations, and therefore might actually give you more of a glow. If that's what you want. So, there's that. Then, next up, another golden oldie, the Essence Bronzing Powder Matte. Which is a matte bronzing powder. It's, as you can tell, very well loved and also pretty orange. So, yeah, we're just gonna hope for the best. Okay, it is indeed very orange. I'm just gonna use it like I used to use my bronzer as usually. As sort of a bronze contour, so I'm basically just applying it very, very spread out around my contour areas, because, you know, making an actual shadow with this just isn't going to work at all whatsoever. Like, with the very pale concealer beneath it, it's already pushing it as a bronzer. So yeah. Just gonna spread it out, try to blend it. Broken. Yep, that's what we're gonna use. This is the Essence Silky Touch Blush in the shade Eliza Cherry. I actually still have, from the same time period, another Essence Silky Touch Blush and also a Catrice Blush, but I still actually use those two regularly. The reason I used this one back in the day, but I stopped using it, was because it does give a lot of results. But it actually gives a bit too much of a result, so we're going to very carefully, very, very carefully apply half a molecule of this. What always really surprised me about this stuff, by the way, like, is, like, see how pigmented it is, like. And from a budget brand, like, it is a good blush in the sense of it is very pigmented and it's very good in that sense, but I would expect for a budget brand to cater more to young girls who don't want to accidentally turn themselves into a clown by being a little bit too heavy-handed in the morning. So yeah, it's a good blush, but maybe for the wrong audience. For highlighter, the lid broke off on this one too. This is the Makeup Academy Under Your Skin Highlighter. I know I still use this one, but actually, when I was looking for a highlighter for this challenge, I realized I still actually use all my highlighters. I don't know if they still sell this, quite frankly, but anyway. So I figured I'd just use this one because I like it, and it is technically a very old one, so yeah. I just don't have a forgotten one. Then eyes. This isn't going to be intricate enough for me to actually have to zoom in all the way, so we're just going to keep it at this distance. Back in the day, I used to love the Catrice Absolute Nude and Absolute Matte Palettes, which combined are pretty much, you know, a bit of a dupe for a naked palette from Urban Decay. So that's good. So yeah, I'm just going to try to still use these. Starting off with a taupe shade in the crease. And by the way, like, even though I don't really use these a lot anymore, when I do still use them very rarely in my daily life off camera, I do still actually like these. I don't actually think they still sell these specific ones, but Catrice, overall, I like the brand. Obviously, with the eyeshadows, you gotta keep in mind they're not as pigmented as, well, basically the stuff that I regularly use these days. So you're going to have to work a little bit harder to get pigment. But nevertheless, they are actually quite decent in quality. Like, they blend out, they're nice. You know, they do their job, you just need to apply a little bit more of them. But, you know, at the price point, there's really no need to be very sparse with them anyway. Now, over top of that, I'm putting a brown shade with the exact same brush. And one thing that's really, I think, a plus with very cheap eyeshadow palettes. If you're a beginner, then I really do recommend very cheap palettes with not very much... Wow, this concealer is kind of itchy. Anyway, that's probably not a good sign, is it? But the point is, it actually is a good idea if you're a beginner to start off with very cheap eyeshadow. Like, safe, not, you know, really cheap, don't know what's in their dupes. But, like, you know, things like Catrice, budget brands. Just because, one, if you don't end up going on with makeup, it won't be as much of a waste if you only have cheap stuff anyway, you know, waste of your own money, I mean. But also, because it's less pigmented, it's also a bit more safe, I suppose. Like with this, I can just toss it on. I can just toss the dark color on, and I know that despite me applying it over top of a pretty sticky cream eyeshadow, cream concealer, I'm calling that stuff a lot of stuff. A very sticky cream concealer, which is barely set because my powder was almost finished. That doesn't help with the blending, but because the eyeshadow isn't very pigmented, like it's pigmented enough, but it's not so pigmented that I won't be able to blend it out. I know that however much I apply, I know I'll still be able to blend it, which is rather a nice thing to be sure about. Then beneath my eyebrow bone, I'm just going to apply a little bit of an off-white shade. Which really is something that I actually still do these days with the exact same brush. Before I continue on the eyes, I'm just going to use another shade from this matte palette, the most warm brown shade, to fill in my eyebrows, because I just used to basically use whatever I had in my hands for that. Including this brush, I'm actually going to use the other side for my eyelid, but this one is angled, this side, so yeah, why not? So yeah, I'm just basically going to fill them in. By the way, looking back at those days when I used to regularly use these products, my eyebrows were not good. Like, I made my eyebrows so incredibly thin because I wanted them to be versatile. I wanted to be able to fill them in however I wanted. But most of the time they just ended up being ridiculously thin, like pencil thin, like really thin. And kind of bald looking. It wasn't a good look on me. I'm glad I've grown in that aspect. I'm really glad I've grown out my eyebrows because I really do feel like this looks a lot better on me than the barely there brow that I used to have. Really was not a good look on me. But anyway, back to the eyelids. For that I'm just going to use a shimmery nude shade from the other nude palette. And the lid is coming off this one as well. It's a curse that just keeps following me. Or maybe I'm just not careful enough. Anyway, I'm just applying this all over the eyelid. On second thought, in the outer corner, I'm putting a slightly darker shade of brown shimmer to blend it together. And then in the inner corner, a very pale shimmery nude shade, just as a highlight. Just in time before I put the palette away, I remembered I also use a very dark eyeshadow between my lower lashes a lot of the times. And because I have a forgotten liquid liner for the top lashes, I thought I'd just make sure the bottom is a bit darker too. I might regret this in very new and creative ways, but I'm using a shimmery white pencil on my waterline. Which is barely visible and really not worth getting an eye infection over, so I hope I'm not gonna get one. Now, the Rimmel Exaggerate Eyeliner is going to be my other risk of eye infection today. This one is ancient. It has a very short, like, I actually did use the lightest eyeliner. It just has a very stump point, while I actually prefer a more long, flexible brush. But nevertheless, we're just going to hope it still works. Okay, this was the final run of this particular eyeliner, because it's officially completely empty now. I do actually remember now why I loved it, because of the very tiny stump brush, this is literally the only eyeliner that I can manage to make a kitten wing with, rather than having these weird, really big flared out things that I always end up with. Which I like, but still, it's nice to have the option to go subtle. Anyway, yeah, actually, I think I'm gonna repurchase this, because I still actually do adore it. For lashes, I'm also going to use Rimmel, the Wonderfully Real, which, to be fair, I still sometimes use as well. However, I don't really keep around that many empty mascaras, so this is the one for today. To be fair about this mascara, though, it used to be really, really nice before it dried out and got the consistency of a molten eye pencil, pretty much. Not a good consistency for a mascara. Like, it is the sort of mascara that you gotta be careful with, because if you're not careful, you're going to get it everywhere, because the brush is kind of big and pointy at parts, at the base specifically. However, it does give very, very nice, big, full lashes. When it's not half dried out, that is. So, yeah, good mascara, just be careful with it, and also don't let it dry out. Okay, so far so good. I actually had expected a lot more drama and disaster by now. Lucky. Anyway, for the lips, I'm also going to use Rimmel because I apparently used to have a thing for Rimmel. I still like Rimmel, I just somehow forgot it existed. A little bit, I guess. Might need to buy more Rimmel stuff again. But anyway, for the lips, I'm going to use their Moisture Renew lipstick in Funtime Fuchsia, which I'm pretty sure they don't sell anymore. But it's a very nice color and it's not green patchy and it also doesn't have hair sprouting out of it, so I'm not pretty sure, but I'm at least hoping that it's not poisonous. Let's hope for the best. Okay, so here we have it. I gotta say, I still actually adore the color. I don't really wear colors like this very often anymore on the lips, but it's still really, really pretty. Extremely pretty. It fits my nails too at the moment. My nails are kind of lighter, but still. Yeah, I think I might actually go look if they still have a shade that sort of compares to this one. But yeah, I didn't actually use the Believe in setting spray, so I believe we're done now. So let's just head to the show part and then finish the video. So here we are, the final results. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video and I'm actually really surprised how well this turned out. Like, let's just take some things into consideration here. I didn't use a proper face moisturizing base beforehand, not one that's meant for oily skin at least. I also used an old cream concealer all over the face combined with a powder that was pretty much empty to begin with. And then there's the fact, of course, that my blush was a bit too pigmented, my bronzer is very orange, and the eyeliner and mascara were pretty much dried out and empty. So really, taking all of that in combination, this is actually, to me, a very good result. Like, I'm surprised I'd still go outside wearing this. Soon, not after 2 hours, because this base isn't gonna last for very long. But anyway, yeah, again, I hope you enjoyed watching this. If you did enjoy this video, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to see me do makeup without using products that are probably expired, you can always subscribe to my channel. For now, at any rate, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!